Good evening. It is now 11 p.m. in Samoa and 10 p.m. in American Samoa, and we have significant weather underway across the island chain as Tropical Cyclone Evan continues to meander around the islands as it also continues to intensify. We have a brand new update from the U.S. Joint Typhoon Warning Center. Maximum sustained winds are still 80 knots, so that is the same as the last advisory. But we are still looking at more in the way of intensification being forecast over the next couple of days. They're now forecasting a peak intensity of 110 knots as the storm begins to move away from American Samoa and more so toward Fiji, which also keep in mind, interests there need to be paying very close attention to this storm as it looks as though the storm will head in your direction in the extended range. But more importantly, for interests out across Samoa and American Samoa in the short term, due to the lack of steering currents, the storm is expected to remain nearly stationary for the next 24 to 36 hours, and any area that is already experiencing flooding is going to face even more significant flooding as time goes on, because we're going to be talking about copious rainfall totals, unlike probably anything you've ever seen before, as this storm just hovers over the islands for an extended duration. Furthermore, if the storm reaches the peak intensity of 110 knots, which is the forecast, as it starts to move away from the islands, if those maximum sustained winds are just offshore, and we're talking in the range of 125 to 130 miles per hour, even if the islands themselves are not experiencing winds of that magnitude, they're not going to be that far off. We're still talking about, at the very least, Category 2, if not potentially even Category 3 equivalent hurricane or typhoon winds lashing some of the coastal communities, and this is something that hopefully everyone has made preparations for. Now, as we look deeper into the forecast track and more at the specifics, the latest forecast track does not take the storm directly over American Samoa, but as you're already beginning to see, the center of circulation does not have to pass directly over any islands for those islands to still be impacted by some rather treacherous weather. So if this center comes anywhere close to Pago Pago, you could still be dealing with some very strong winds and heavy rainfall. Since we are heading deeper into the overnight hours, we have lost the ability to analyze the visible satellite, and as you can see on the animation, we transition from the visible daytime imagery to the overnight standard infrared, but nonetheless, we can still easily make out the rough position as to where the center is located. And usually, as the cyclones become stronger and more organized, it becomes easier to pinpoint the center over time. And as we look at this latest animation as it updates once again, you can see that the center of circulation appears to be nearly stationary directly over Upolu. And this is concerning because this is only going to add to the rainfall totals that have already taken shape across the islands, especially in some of the higher terrain where the rainfall totals are maximized. And probably the biggest threat to more loss of life will be inland flooding as the rainfall totals continue to rise. That's not to discount the storm surge threat, especially as the storm continues to intensify, however, because the rising water levels will continue to be an issue, if not become even more of an issue, over the next 24 to 36 hours. Also, for interest out across Pago Pago, as you can see, more in the way of cloud cover and convection in the form of thunderstorms are moving over the area, and although the strongest convection is out across Samoa, you're going to be getting into more and more of the action, and it looks as though right now that maybe the worst of the winds will remain just to the west of American Samoa, but that's not saying much at this time because it still looks like you could be inundated by some rather strong winds and weather, as we've been saying all along in the video and the last several videos. So please do not let your guard down there, and we're still going to be going through this storm for quite some time. A different version of the enhanced infrared is also giving us more clues as to where exactly the center of circulation is located, and once again, all evidence is suggesting that the center of circulation is hugging the coastline of Upolu at this current hour, and if anything, a slight drift over the next 6 hours toward the north may begin, but it's going to wobble back and forth here as the steering currents remain weak for the next day, and that is the main reason why we're not expecting the cyclone to move all that much. Over time, however, a ridge will begin to develop to the south, and this ridge will help to turn the storm back toward the southwest, but it's going to take another day and a half for that to happen. Now, I know that this graphic may be slightly more difficult to read, but this is an overall view of the Southwest Pacific, and you can see the Samoa Island chain out here. And what this graphic displays is the oceanic heat content of the basin. Now, that is slightly different than just looking at the sea surface temperatures. This oceanic heat content also accounts for the water temperature slightly below the surface. And this becomes an increasingly important factor to consider, especially for tropical cyclones that are nearly stationary, because ordinarily over time the strong winds associated with the cyclone allow some of those cooler waters below the surface to mix toward the top, and then the net effect is for surface temperature cooling, and then the cyclone begins to lose its fuel supply, that being the warm water needed to fuel the thunderstorm activity. But in cases where there is high oceanic heat content, the amount of upwelling is almost irrelevant because the warm waters are there at both the surface and slightly below, so even if we do get some upwelling, the waters around here are still expected to be favorable enough to support more steady intensification for the next 2 days. It is also very concerning to see that the tropical cyclone is currently oriented underneath an upper-level ridge, and upper-level ridges are favorable for tropical cyclone development because they promote more in the way of light upper-level winds and no vertical wind shear. And as we turn on the color representation, as you start to get into these blue and navy blue colors, these are regions of the atmosphere that have less than 5 to 10 knots of shear, and if you combine areas like this with very warm water temperatures and oceanic heat content like we just saw, this is the perfect recipe for more in the way of steady intensification. So there is little doubt that the Joint Typhoon Warning Center forecast is valid with the idea that this will be strengthening into at least a Category 3 cyclone, and interests across Samoa will have to closely monitor this storm in the event that it begins to strengthen perhaps even a little bit more or faster than indicated. In this video, I'm going to spare you from the details explaining why the storm is going to be steered the way it will, as we just covered that in a video posted just a few hours ago. But one of the final things that I would like to show is the latest run of the EC-MWF model, which has become available within the past hour and a half. And as I mentioned earlier in this video, it looks like we may begin to see at least a slight drift toward the north over the next 6 hours, and it appears that the European model is implying that by taking the center just to the north of Samoa. But even if it does drift toward the north just a little, the southern eye wall is still going to be heavily impacting all throughout this region, and you're going to still be seeing cyclone force winds and very heavy rainfall. And it looks like the model is continuing to intensify the storm, but more importantly, I would like to point out that this is now the 36-hour time frame, and as you can see, there's been hardly any motion. If anything, it's starting to wobble more so toward the west, and finally beyond 36 hours, that is when it will start to make its march closer toward the nation of Fiji. And then that is something that we will have to figure out in terms of the forecast down the road once we're done with the impacts for Samoa. And finally, this is one last look at the enhanced infrared satellite animation. And within the past one or two frames, you can start to make out the center of the circulation, or the eye-like feature, beginning to spread over the northern coast of Upolu. So it looks like that northern drift is occurring. And again, due to the very weak steering, the center of the circulation could just meander all throughout this region over the next day to day and a half. But overall, the storm still appears to be intensifying. That eye-like feature is becoming more pronounced on this enhanced infrared animation. So definitely stay hunkered down, and if you happen to be in a safe shelter already, please stay there until the storm begins to wind down. But it's going to be quite some time before that begins to happen. So best of luck to everyone down there, and keep it tuned to your local emergency management agencies for the latest evacuation information pertaining to your area. And if at all possible, please go ahead and use 28storms.com/cyclone as a supplementary source of information throughout the duration of the event.